Welcome back this week to Fridays in the Field. We're back this week in central Nebraska. We've made our way all across the state, and we visit here again with grower Andrew McHargue, Chapman, Nebraska farmer. He gives us an update on what he's been up to since we last talked to him in May.
We had planting was pretty dry overall. We had a few little rains here and there and got pushed back, and then it just turned hot and dry like most guys in central Nebraska know, and we were hilling corn and getting pipe out on stuff that wasn't tall enough and all that kind of stuff. We got a much needed rain there two nights ago, and it's been really great to have some cooler weather and some rain, and we didn't get any hail or wind with that, so we're really, really thankful for where we're at right now.
McHargue mentions that the weather could not have been more timely, because although it's nice out now, it sure has been a hot June.
It was getting pretty ugly. I don't think we would have, and we may have even lost some yield this last week before it rained, just with the pivot corners and stuff we couldn't get. But luckily we did get a little bit, and it was just one of those things we can't put it on as well as the good Lord can. So
now, the last time we caught up with McHargue, he went into detail on the different crops that he grows: organic, white corn, conventional. And this week he talked a little bit more about some of the management practices that they have to employ, especially when it comes to weed pressure.
Corn, you know, we started with our commercial corn, our white corn, yellow corn. We got that in the ground really timely, and that looked really well. But, you know, like we talked last time, we didn't get started planting till April 28th. And things got, you know, the beans probably got pushed back further than we would have liked after a few rains and some breakdowns. Once we finally got to finished up planting, it was probably a little later than we wanted it, but I think overall the crops still look really good. On our organic farming, it's been kind of dry, so that has helped us with weed control. It just seems like when it's raining, we get more weeds growing quicker. So, I mean, that's been one benefit of the dry weather on our operation, is just being able to be a little more on top of the weeds on the organic portion of our operation. So with the organic crops, you know, it's just, you know, it really seems like it has to do a lot with Mother Nature. We got this year, like I said, we got planted when it was pretty dry. We had good moisture underneath and we had good temperature, so the crop shot out of the ground quickly and we were able to stay in front of the weeds pretty well. But the whole thing is just getting that crop up to a point where you can cultivate it and beat the weeds. We have some beans that got put in a little later, and it seemed like, as far as organic beans go, we just fought the weeds more on that, and we fight the weeds more in beans than our conventional crops too. So it just seems like figuring out how to fight the weeds, organic or conventional, in our beans specifically has been a challenge.
It'll be a busy next few weeks until we get back around to McHargue here in central Nebraska. He talks a little bit about some of the things he's looking forward to in that time.
Yeah, I think we're kind of past what I call hell week of just getting everything running and getting everything hilled. We still got some popcorn to cultivate and hill yet, and some beans and some field work. So I would say hopefully in the next 3 weeks here we'll have our field work done, still have irrigation to get going. But, you know, from here on the real focus is just keeping irrigation going and doing a good job watering our crops. That's kind of will be the main focus from here on out.
Thanks again for joining us on this week's Fridays in the Field. We'll be back again to check on grower Andrew McHargue of central Nebraska as we make our way all across the state over the next couple of weeks for round two. And until then, you can find all of our Fridays in the Field coverage by visiting ruralradio.com, liking us on Facebook, or following us on Twitter.